Hello everybody, my name is Jatin George, and I'd like to welcome you to the Radar series. This is going to be a series of episodes where we bring in several subject matter experts to talk about the latest trends in the industry, and also about how TI is bringing solutions to help them innovate within their respective fields. Today we have with us a very special guest joining us all the way from Italy. I'd like to welcome Lorenzo Nava, Product Manager at INXPECT. Lorenzo, thank you so much for joining us today.
Hello everyone, and thanks for having me.
Awesome. Well, let's jump right in. So Lorenzo, let's talk a little bit about the company itself. So INXPECT designs and builds radar for industrial safety. And of course, there's a lot of emphasis on functional safety, and there is focus on robotics. Could you tell me a little bit about why safe radar sensors are required in robotics and some of these other industrial applications?
Sure. When we have to deal with operator safety, we have to comply with the highest level of safety standard. And this is particularly important in a robotic application. So having a certified radar is very important. And the safety is not the only aspect that we need to consider, but we also need to consider that productivity in robotic application is very important, because robots are typically used in tasks that need a lot of speed and need to perform each and every task, saving time and with an optimized performance. Of course, for this reason, it's important to have devices that are also very robust to and can work in any environment conditions. So we need to think that most of the robotic process take place in environment where we have dust, where we have smoke, where we can have light that might affect the performance of some optical devices. In particular, if we consider outdoor applications, this property of the radar to be very robust in any conditions is very beneficial, because doing that, we can use the radar outside, keeping a very high level of performance in the application and guaranteeing the safety because of the robustness in any weather conditions. Another very important aspect is the possibility of the radar to work and detect the movement in a volume, so in a 3D space. That will help overcoming some of the limitation of the optical devices that typically sense the presence of the operator on a 2D plane. Detecting the operator in a volume is particularly important when you have to deal with restart prevention applications.
So, Lorenzo, you talked about some of the key advantages of using radar in these types of applications, and you also touched on functional safety a little bit. I've been hearing some excited news about your latest release with the SPV-01 safe radar sensor. Could you tell us a little bit more about the SPV-01?
Sure. The SPV-01 is our first 60 gigahertz MIMO safety radar system, and it complies with the highest safety standard, and we achieved the SIL-2 and PLD Category 3 certification. That allows our device to be suitable for several different industrial applications, starting from robotic applications to AGVs to gantry machinery, anti-collision, and a lot of several different other applications. The SBV01 implements two main safety functions: access detection and restart prevention. Access detection, of course, avoids the operator to enter a dangerous area, stopping the machinery. And restart prevention is a very important feature that avoids the machinery to restart as long as the operator is inside the dangerous area. This is particularly important when you have to monitor area during maintenance operation, for example. The SBV01 bases its capability of detecting people on a motion detection algorithm. This algorithm can sense even very small movement, like the movement of the chest when the person is breathing. This means that the device is able also to filter out all the static objects. And this is particularly useful when, for example, you use the system in a very complex environment where you have a lot of different objects. And this typically requires an optical device, a very fine tuning of the configuration, while with the radar, it's very simple. The radar itself filters out all the static objects, detecting a guaranteed safety because it can still detect the operator because of its micro movement. The SBV01 can sense the presence of person in a range from 50 centimeters to 5 meters. And it has a field of view of 100 degrees on the horizontal field of view and 20 degrees on the vertical field of view. Especially on the horizontal field of view, the angle is tunable, so you can configure the angle from 10 to 100 degrees with 10 degrees resolution.
So the SPV01 is based on TI's 60 gigahertz IWR6843 sensor. What are some of the unique features on IWR6843 that you would say, you know, made SPV01 possible? And then from the functional safety side, right, how would you say the SIL-2 certification on 6843, as well as the supporting collateral like functional safety manual, the FMEDA, and the software diagnostics library, how did some of those things help you streamline some of the safety certification process for SPV01?
Well, this is our second generation of safety certified sensors, and the first generation was based on an IC at 24 gigahertz, and that IC came without any support safety for the safety documentation and without any certification. So it took a lot of effort to our team to achieve the safety certification and the safety level that we needed to cover the industrial application that we have targeted. With the TI IWR6843, that process was speed up a lot because of the functional safety collateral information that allowed us to streamline the entire design process and basically focus the team on the tasks that are useful to optimize the performance. For example, optimizing the integration between the hardware and the software and developing the algorithm that are the core know-how of INXPECT with respect to the performance of our radar in the industrial safety field. This was possible because all the information that we got from TI and all the software that support the safety aspects allows us to save a lot of time and to optimize the development. Because at that point, it was no longer required to take care about all the safety mechanism and all the safety aspect, but all the documentation provided by TI allowed us to comply very quickly with the requirements of the safety standard in the industrial field. For this reason, basically, what was provided by TI allowed us to save a lot of time in terms of development and, of course, make a product that is far richer in terms of functionality and flexibility.
So, Lorenzo, you talked about how the functional safety certification on IWR6843 and the supporting functional safety collateral really enabled you to cut down that development time and focus more on the differentiation and the flexibility that you can offer to your customers. Let's talk about that a little bit. Could you shed some light on some of the key features of the SPV01 when it comes to industrial robotics applications and how it helps safeguard those industrial robots?
Yeah, well, the SPV01 has a very important feature that is the volumetric detection. And this is very important when you have to address the restart prevention task inside the robotic cell, for example. In that case, operators sometimes, when he's performing some maintenance operation, can find himself in hazardous situation because, for example, his feet are no longer on the ground and his detection cannot be guaranteed by optical devices that scan the area just on a plane. For this reason, having a volumetric device allows to track the operator in any position and in any condition inside, for example, a robotic cell. When we speak about modularity and flexibility of the system, and we can say the SPV01 system is very flexible because you can set the sensor and install that from the ground to the ceiling, and you can possibly combine the device in several different configuration and several different solutions so that you can address different layout of the cell and different layout in general of robotic application, but any industrial applications. Because of its robustness, we can address some of the biggest problems in the industrial environment. Now robots are used more and more in the so-called 3D tasks that are dirty, dangerous, and dull tasks. These tasks, for example, are painting operations. Painting operations require a lot of precision. It's a very repetitive task, and a robot can do that very well because of the precision in the painting of the piece and the possibility to be very accurate, very accurate. For this reason, the SPV can guarantee the safety in this application that are typically even very dangerous because they are performed in environment that are potentially explosive. Optical devices in this environment could have some limitations because of the paint that are sprayed in the air and they can cover the lens of the laser scanner. Another typical application can be welding, where the welding operation produces sparks or very bright spots that can trigger some false alarm in the optical devices. Radar, of course, is not sensitive to the light, so it can operate in a very reliable way and guarantee the safety of these operations.
So, Lorenzo, how does the SPV-01 compare to existing light curtains and laser scanners? Can the SPV-01 be viewed as an alternative to safe LiDARs out there, or do you see them more as complementary sensors?
Yeah, that's a very good question. Thanks for asking. Although the two technology might be very similar for some aspects, they are based on sensitive technologies that are quite different. So from one side, we have the laser scanner that typically have more accuracy in the detection of the position of the operator. So it's very precise in localizing the position of the operator inside the area. And on the other side, we have the radar that are typically very robust and can work in several different environment conditions and sense the world in 3D. So they can detect the position of the operator on the whole volume and on a 3D space, not just on a plane as the laser scanner did. For this reason, these two devices are used typically in different applications. But sometimes they can also be used as complementary devices. So for example, we might want to use the SPV-01 when we have to deal with restart prevention in an application, but in the same application, we might want to use the laser scanner to detect just part of the body. So for example, we want to detect just the limb, and for that purpose, the SPV-01 is not suitable, so we might want to use together the laser scanner and the SBV01 to protect and perform a very good safety coverage of the application.
Understood. Now, from an end application standpoint, you know, when you talk about limb detection and restart prevention, we've been focusing on the SBV01 mainly from a robotic standpoint. Could you provide some examples of other applications where customers can also leverage the SBV01?
In the past, for this purpose, safety mats and light curtains were used to put a safety zone all around the machinery. But in that case, these devices occupy a lot of space. The radar device, and this is a new solution, and we probably reinvented a little bit this application by putting the radar on the moving part of the machinery and just monitoring where the danger actually is. So the safety zone just moves together with the danger zone of the machinery and saving for sure a lot of space and allowing the operator to perform tasks where the mobile part of the machinery is not present. This will save a lot of time and increase the performance, the overall performance of the applications.
Lorenzo, what about compatibility?
Well, the SPV01 has several different interfaces, so you have the possibility to connect the system to different equipment like PLCs or robot controllers. The SBV system bus provides industrial Ethernet safety field bus, ProfiSafe in this case, that allows to exchange safety information between the system and the PLC or robot controller. Safety information can transfer some details that are not possible to retrieve using simple digital IOs. In that case, you can use the safety field bus to dynamically set in real time different parameters of the application, like the range, so you can increase and decrease the range of the sensor in real time using the safety Ethernet field bus. And you can also retrieve information like the position of the operator in real time. We provide also an Ethernet interface that is can be used to both configure the system, but also to retrieve some useful data using the Modbus Fieldbus protocol. Again, this is another possibility. It is not safe, so it can transport just non-safety information, but it can be very useful when you have to debug the application or simply retrieve useful information from the system. We have also, of course, digital IOs that can be interfaced to any kind of control system or PLC. The digital IOs are very simple signal that are just interfaced and can provide, for example, alarm status, or the system can receive input signal such as emergency stop signal, restart, muting signal, or it can use the safety input to configure again dynamically different type of setup on our system.
Very cool. Lorenzo, thank you so much for joining us today. It's really exciting to see what you've developed with the SBV01 and the types of problems that it's solving, not only in robotics, but also other applications within the industrial space. So again, thank you so much for taking the time to be with us today.
Yeah, it was really a pleasure, and thank you for your availability and for having me today. And let me thank you again for the good cooperation that we had so far with Texas Instruments.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys for joining us for the first episode of the Radar series. We have more great sessions, more great guests coming up. So don't forget to tune in for the next one. Thank you so much.